Hey there! In this video, I'll be taking a look at Obsidian, a software that allows you to organize your knowledge. Now, just two things before I start. One, I am not in any way related with the app or its developers. Secondly, it literally only came out a couple of hours ago as I am recording this. As such, it's a beta and various things may have changed by the time you're watching this video. Now, I love to think about ways to organize my own knowledge. One such way, and one that I especially like, is the Zettelkasten method. If you don't know what that is, the briefest description I can give you right now is that it's a folder, and each file you put in the folder corresponds to roughly one idea. You then link these files to one another, give them a unique name, make them as small as possible, and doing so allows you to keep your knowledge neatly organized, and hopefully it'll inspire you to form even more ideas. Now, that was me trying to compress this giant topic in a sentence. So if you want to delve deeper, I'll leave some links in the description below to my own and other people's articles on the subject. This brings us to Obsidian. Obsidian is a piece of software which, like others before it, wants to help us organize our knowledge. Now, I'll go over the pros, then the cons, and ultimately I'll give you my opinion on it. Number one, this is a first-class Zettelkasten app. This is not software that was designed with something else in mind and was wrangled to work with Zettelkasten. The developers of Obsidian mention Zettelkasten in their marketing, their menus, their UI, so they know people will use it for this system. It's got full link support, full tag support. Sure, it's not the only app of this kind, but it's nice to know. Also, perhaps even more important, your notes always stay as plain text files on the system. Obsidian doesn't ask you to store your private info on their servers or to convert your text files into some proprietary format, nothing like that. If one day you ever want to quit Obsidian for another app, you won't lose anything. This is extremely important. In fact, if it weren't the case, I probably wouldn't even be reviewing this product in the first place. Another thing that this app does well is the graph view. Now, you click here, and there you go, a visual representation of all of your notes and links between them. I am a visual person. I like to visualize things in my mind, and the whole reason Zettelkasten is effective at managing your knowledge is because of the links it lets you create in between notes. Now, these links are fundamental to the system, so isn't it nice to see a visual representation of these links? Yes, you could do this before, but it required you to go through some extra steps. Download this, run that. Here, it was as easy as clicking on that button. Sure, this is a small number of notes, but it should be able to scale and handle your load, no problem. Number three, backlinks. Probably the number one question I get regarding this method on my blog or elsewhere is about backlinking. Now, here's the gist of the problem if you're not aware. So you're creating your note, you're adding outward links to other notes, as you should. So what happens to that other note, the one you link to? Shouldn't it too get a link back to this note? Now, unless you went and did it manually for each note, there was no simple way to keep track of all of these backlinks. Up until literally 2 days ago, I replied to a question someone asked me on the internet, and I said that simply, well, there is no good solution. Obsidian sort of changed that. You click on this button right here, and there you go. That's everything that links back to the note you are editing right now. Again, like the graph, this too was technically possible before, but only with some custom scripts. It wasn't tidy, and it required technical knowledge. Here, it's just a button away. Plus, as an extra, if you ever rename a note, Obsidian will just automatically update all of the links to it in your system. Now, that's neat. Number four, UI flexibility. You can have multiple notes open at the same time. You can split windows in about a trillion different ways. And yeah, this doesn't seem too important at first, except many times while you're typing away at a note, you come up with a new idea or you realize something you're writing about should be separated into its own node. So you just open a new node and start writing. Then at that point, you will either do the same thing again and open a new one, or you'll go back to the previous node. With some other apps, this required some hacks. A common trick was to insert a special character that indicated sort of where you left off. You opened the new node, and when you were done, you searched for that character to continue, to sort of go back. Now, some other apps offer back and forward buttons, and while they are a huge improvement over other tricks, it's still very linear. It doesn't really allow you to branch out and splinter a node in two or three and still have them all open at the same time. As you can see on the screen, with Obsidian, you can really play around with this and sort of map your thinking onto the Windows system. That's really beneficial, I believe. I've been praising this app left and right, so it's probably time to talk about something that the app doesn't do very well. And really, it's only one thing. The issue here is that this is not a native Mac, Windows, or Linux app. It's made with Electron, which means that it's basically a browser tab repackaged as an app. Now, this by itself doesn't mean much. There are Electron apps which I think are great, such as VS Code, for instance. But it does mean that things like this can happen, where it's actually using 1 GB of RAM. Now, is 1 GB a lot? Well, for video editing software, maybe not so much. But for a text editor, yes, it is a lot. In fact, I can see how this can be a deal breaker for a lot of people. But then again, there are other apps made with Electron, like VS Code, which take up much, much less memory. So this is just likely more about fixing the beta bugs and making sure memory is properly managed. It's not something about Electron itself. So, will it become my main Zettelkasten software, and should you download it? Well, the benefits it gives are incredible, such as the backlinks, the graphs, and the flexible UI. Plus, it doesn't trap your files. So I think I'm going to be giving it a fair shot over the next couple of weeks, and if I find that the performance and memory usage are too much of a deal breaker, I'll simply switch back to IA Writer. Ultimately, if the features I mentioned are something you might be interested in, I suggest you go give it a try. I left a link in the description. It won't affect your existing notes, so there's no harm. If, however, you're happy with your current setup, maybe with a more lightweight app, and you don't really feel the need for the extra features, then perhaps you can just keep it as a bookmark and check back later when it's a little more stable. Well, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.